Take the long way home. Hi, I'm Angel. Thanks for stopping by. I'm about to turn off this highway and take a longer way home, and so I thought I'd share my two cents about that real quick, which is just that I think, Jay Samit who wrote Disrupt You, I believe, which I still have not actually read, I've just heard him speak a lot about and other people make reference to, and that idea resonates with me a lot because I think it's important to change your perspective every now and then, take the long way home. Pardon me. changing your perspective, changing your routine, changing the track that you're on and giving yourself a chance to grow, to experience something new, to, just breathe different air sometimes is important. Yep, I was thinking about both how I'm about to turn off and take a longer route home. It's not that much longer, just a little, but I'm going to stop and take some photos, so it's going to take me quite a bit longer. And that's, you know, all part of the process is of taking the long way home for me, is going out of my way, putting a little pause on the hurry up and get to where I'm going button, and just allowing myself to appreciate the scenery, be in the moment. It's not like I'm just gonna drive off into not knowing, although sometimes that's a really fun thing to do too, as long as you got enough gas in the tank, to explore new roads and stuff. But in this case, I have some property off another road this way that I haven't been to in a while, and I keep meaning to take a different way home. And today I happen to have the energy and the time, so it occurs to me I'm doing it, even though it will add a few hours to my trip probably. We'll see. We're about to see. And that's the exciting thing about taking the long way home or going off your regular routine. And especially I was thinking about how, I think it's important in the actual driving of places and the navigating of all aspects of your life. I was also thinking about how in relationships, if we don't bring disruption and new things into the relationship, then other things will happen to cause that. And I think that's true in a lot of aspects of life. Same with like business, same thing. If you're not disrupting your business a little, which is what Jay Samit's book is really about, and thinking outside the box or trying to outdo yourself or tossing out ideas and brainstorming from a different perspective now and then you're bound to probably get stagnant, maybe, enter that death cycle. Death part of the life cycle? I don't know how to phrase that, but you know what I mean. Don't let it get stale and stagnant and die. Instead, disrupt the pattern now and then. Take the long way home now and then. See what happens when you change it up a bit. Try a new meal, try a new routine, try a new hat. I almost just bought a new hat, but of course, it's not really taking the long way home or getting out of disrupting my routine because I've been buying hats lately of all different sorts. So, in fact, look, I bought this one not too long ago. I didn't put on over my glasses too well. Anyway, my turn is coming up. I hope you're loving what you do, doing what you love, and disrupting you when it seems appropriate, and sometimes when it doesn't seem appropriate. The thing is also about disruption and taking the long way home and being comfortable with being uncomfortable is that it prepares you, trains you to handle bigger and better problems, and then you can pay bigger and better bills. I don't know if that's your goal or not. That's one of my goals, though, so yay for me. I'm doing pretty well. Uh-oh, I just noticed that there's a high wind warning where I was about to head off. Anyway, I'm gonna stop in and Google a map. As usual, there are lots of ways you can connect to me and support me, linked to in the description below. And as always, I wish you peaceful conflict resolution, love and lightheartedness, laughter, playfulness, new roads, adventures, creativity. Don't forget to drive forward.